वेलकम टू ट्यूसडे टेक्निकल टॉक। टुडेज टॉपिक इज ट्राइंगल or triangles, we can say there are different types of triangles. We have been covering patterns in the last few videos, and now this is where we look at symmetrical triangle, ascending triangle, and descending triangle. So what are these triangles? Triangles are basically sideways movement. They are into like a consolidation move. And let's first look at symmetrical triangle, right? What is symmetrical triangle? When both your lines, one is going down and one is going up, that's your symmetrical triangle one. Second point, they at least need 4 points, means one trend line will have 2 points, another trend line will have 2 points. That means a triangle will have 4 points, right? Third, the most important is after the triangle, which is like a sideways movement, it breaks out. It should break out with high volume, right? That's price pattern volume. If it crosses 60 on RSI, that's great. Plus, once it goes and it makes a CIP, which is change in polarity on the triangle, that's great. That would be an excellent opportunity to buy further. And let me tell you the 10x nugget. The triangle should break out before 3/4 of the triangle. What do you mean by 3/4 of the triangle? Let's say this triangle goes like this, this goes towards the top like this. That is not, and then it goes out of the triangle. That does not make sense. The triangle has to break out well before the 3/4. Means from here till here, this is the 3/4. That's very important. So this is symmetrical triangle, and you can see more examples like this where you can see this breakout on the upside. Now symmetrical triangle is basically a triangle which can be a continuation triangle or a reversal triangle. What do you mean by continuation? Continuation means uptrend, sideways, uptrend. That's continuation. Reversal means uptrend, sideways, downtrend. That's called reversal triangle, right? So these are some of the nuggets which I shared with you in this triangle video which I'm doing. I hope you are learning from this. These are very powerful, especially when you are in a trended market. Market has a typical pattern of going up, then forming a consolidation. Mostly the consolidation is either a rectangle or a triangle. I think I already covered rectangle in one of the past videos, and this is on triangle. So when you get a triangle or a rectangle, that means it's a consolidation phase. And in technical terms, it could be a squeeze phase. After what comes after squeeze or consolidation is a trend market, trending market. Right. So let's look at more examples. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if you see this triangle has gone slightly towards the edge. Right. That's what I mean by it should break out well before 3/4. It's still like 4/5 of the triangle. This is nice. Let's look at this one. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And break out well before the 3/4. It does not go like towards the end. Otherwise, it automatically goes out of the triangle, right? That's not a breakout. It should break out like this. Now comes one more important part. What is the target? The target for triangle is the depth of the triangle. So this is the highest depth you can see. So if this much is the depth, then that much is the triangle target. So we got the entry, we got the rules, we got the points, we got the target. We also got a re-entry if it comes back to the support. And what comes as a failure? What is a failure? Failure means if it goes back into the triangle, if it goes below the trend line, the triangle is out, right? So that's symmetrical triangles we saw. It comes in as a continuation pattern or as a reversal pattern as well. So that's another one nice triangle. If you look at these 2 points and this, that's a breakdown. Now this is like a reversal pattern. It goes up, triangle goes down. This is called reversal, right? But we don't have to worry whether it's a reversal or a continuation, because we are going to trade only after confirmation. We are not going to trade in anticipation. Do you get that? Only after confirmation, right? So that's more on more triangles. Now let's look at ascending triangle. What is ascending? It's ascending towards upward direction. So if you see this, one line is straight. The second line is going up. In that, both the lines are going cross, like one down, one up. That's symmetrical. One line straight and one going up is ascending triangle. Ascending usually will work out as an upward breakout only, because it's already showing higher bottoms. So the breakout usually 99% of the time it will happen on the up side. See, this is a well before the 3/4. Then it comes like a CIP, change in polarity, and then goes up. So that's called ascending triangle, and you can see more of these. Nice looking, the resistance is the same, but the supports are getting higher, 1, 2, and 3. That itself is a sign that trend is bullish because it's not making new bottoms, it's making higher bottoms, right? And then it breaks out. Same triangle target will be replicated, as we mentioned in the previous triangle, ascending triangle. So what's the difference? Symmetrical, one goes up, both the lines are going up opposite. Ascending, one is straight, one is going up. And similarly, we'll have descending also. So let's see this ascending triangle. Like, breakout always in any and every pattern in technical analysis should be with high volume and high momentum. Ideally, high volatility. That means volume, RSI and Bollinger Bands can be combined. I hope the whole series of these videos has turned out into a course on technical analysis. And if you're watching from the first episode till now, that means you already covered most of the basics of stock market or basics of technical analysis. And I think that is more than enough for you to get started in this business, right? So, and then another ascending triangle, ascending, going towards the top. Now, it can have minimum 4 points, like 1 and 2, 1 and 2, but it can have more points also, like 4 and 6 also. Descending triangle. Now, what will happen in descending? The support will be same, the resistance will come down. So that's like descending triangle like this. So the support is same, the resistance is coming down, it usually breaks down. That because it's already a bearish pattern making lower tops. So ascending usually breaks up, descending usually breaks down. And that's why it's called ascending, descending, and they are more of a trending breakout and trending patterns. Right? One more, descending, and supports are same, and then breaks down. Right? So again, the same target would be replicated here. Volume should be there. It should break out well before the end of the triangle. It should not go till the vortex, or this we call the center point. That's where it should not go. Another descending triangle, 1, 2, 3. And the supports are same, and then breakdown. Look at this, very interesting, this small change in polarity, which is like a resistance and then goes down. That's a perfect exit, or sorry, perfect entry with a very, very low risk of trade, right? So that's where you can look at this, another descending triangle, which is going on, which is 1, 2 resistance and 1, 2, 3 supports. So these are where we are going to look at, and this pattern here, you can see that goes down, again comes to the resistance, and then comes down, and then goes towards the target. So this same target here also. So these patterns are really, really very powerful, really very powerful, and it comes in almost every chart. Now let me tell you some more nuggets about it. It can come on daily chart, it can come on weekly chart, it can come on monthly chart, it can come on hourly chart, it can come on 15 minute chart, it can come on 5 minute chart, and all the rules will remain the same. 4 points, volume, momentum and volatility. Consolidation, symmetrical can break out either side. Ascending will break out usually up. Descending will usually break down. And that's all three types of triangles. There are some different kind of triangles called wedges. Upward wedge or a rising wedge or a falling wedge. Maybe I can do a separate video on that because it has some, the properties or the patterns are slightly different there. So we will talk about wedges in a different video. And I hope you enjoyed this video on triangles because I love doing this, and these are very, very simple. If you look at all the videos in this particular series, you will learn a lot about technical analysis. If you're new to my channel, make sure you like, share and subscribe. Also, make sure you put some comments that what did you learn about the triangles and what was the new thing you learned about triangles if you have seen this earlier, but I shared some extra nuggets also. And by the way, anybody can trade. ABCT 360 is happening very soon, and we have a lineup of keynote speakers in this one. This is our favorite program. This has happened 70 times. 45,000 people have attended, 9.8 rating out of 10, and three types of tickets. Make sure you grab your ticket before the event starts, and this is completely changed the way you look at markets. It will completely change the way you look at money making, completely change the way you look at technical analysis. And this program is not only about trading, it's more about life. And I'm so excited for that. It's happening very soon. Make sure you book your ticket at theabct.com. And I will see you in my next video. I hope you enjoy the video on triangles. Thank you so much. Make sure you comment what did you learn and what new topics you would like to learn in the future videos. Till then, good luck and good trading.